2 years ago, I presented, I made a talk here about Hamnet. Yeah, you can watch it online. Not that good, but yeah, to get an impression. There we have our F tools to calculate radio links between different positions and stuff based on the elevation data from the globe. And yeah, to search for possible radio links like Wi-Fi for frequencies above 1 GHz. And since then, some stuff changed. This talk is recycled from an event last year, but I translated it in the last few minutes, so please apologize German words if there are still some left. So the elevation data is provided by different agencies like the NASA or a local government. But that's not enough because there is no information about the surface, if there is if there are trees or bushes or anything. So I rendered the whole globe from OpenStreetMap and made my own 1 by 1 degree tiles, like shown here on the bottom right. And when I zoom in, you have blue for the water, green for anything which is vegetation, and dark gray for civilization, like buildings or anything which is built in the OpenStreetMap. These tiles have the same resolution like the elevation data from the NASA, and so I can tag the elevation data from with the information from OpenStreetMap, and to save data, I use the old data and tag it with minus of 1,000 meters in elevation. And so, like here on the bottom right, the dark red is urban stuff, and so on. In the 16-bit from the SRTM data, I can hide some information. Actually, from the elevation used data is only the over here, the have a mouse? No, yes. It's only this area, so everything else can be used for tagging data in it, in the same data type. So when I have the whole world, I have, I need, I think, 300 gigabytes of data to cover the whole world. And all this stuff can be accessed online. Let's have a look. Yeah, here it's hamnetdb.net/map, and we can point, we can make markers in it. Let's remove it with the right click. Let's place one marker and say, yeah, use this given point, snap from and snap to. And then here on the right side, I have the RF tools where I can calculate stuff like profile. So I have the profile from 2 points with some metadata in it. You can have a look into it and yeah, write me if something's missing, but there should be everything in it from a radio perspective. So. Yes, the Earth curvature is included. You see here the elevation with lines which are lightly banded. And this is not possible for this link, but when we take a really long link, like from here to somewhere here, I think 200 something. You have the Earth curvature here, and the radio curvature is a different one because on the atmosphere you have a refraction, and based on the general refraction index, both is included. So in more detail, I took some beautiful pictures. If in the profile there are trees reaching into the link, based on the OpenStreetMap data, they are painted into the profile. If there is some water, it's blue, and if there's some civilization, it's red. And yeah, we can see this here. If you point your mouse in the profile, you see where you are in the map based on the marker. So if you have a problem and are not sure if this problem really exists, you can look it up and zoom in and check it. You also can change the tower sizes and the labels and the frequency and yeah, the tree size. In Europe, it's up to 30-35 meters. Yeah, you can open a big profile for detail and stuff like this. What else is possible? You can make coverage. So you place one marker and want to look where you can see from this point on. And if there are trees in the way, it's shadowed, like on the left. And if it's not shadowed, like to the right bottom, it's dark. If you have 2 points, you can place 2 points. One is red, one is blue. And if both reaches an area, it's turquoise. Yeah, it's a different color. It's a blue-like color, and so you can see that both reaches this area. And if you want to connect these 2 points, which are not seeing each other, you know I can place a tower there, and then they both can be connected. So if you want to send the calculated simulation to a friend, yeah, to the bottom right there is a PAMA link function, and then the whole stuff can be recalculated later. What else is possible? The whole stuff began with the point-to-point profile and then escalated in a way. And we wanted a panorama function to point the antenna to the target, because when you don't know that the area, it's you need something to help you. And based on the surface information, there is a panorama function where you can make these beautiful pictures. The blue, the red markers are the point of interest shown on the map before. And the webcam is a webcam from a friend, which is public accessible, so you can use it. And also in the picture, the radio horizon with the 4/3 factor of refraction is included. And you can use the refraction for optical or refraction for radio in the simulation. And also here, if you point your mouse on the picture, you see the position on the map. What else is possible? Yeah, we can zoom in and make a more detailed picture. All the tools are on GitHub. They are linked in the help of the website. And the buildings on the bottom, or the trees, or the water, the waves in the water are all geo-referenced. So if you look to the same picture from another angle, the trees appear at the same spot, the waves appear at the same spot. So for the future, maybe there will be a cam slide function that you can move the cam for a video, but that's not possible yet. If you're only interested in the elevation data, there is an LSD mode where only the height is marked in a different color. Here you can see on the bottom the azimuth angles, so that you know the direction exactly. And also the metadata, or the other configuration is shown in the picture. So you can reproduce it or change the settings to get the same picture again later. Also there, for this panorama picture, you can use the permalink function to give it to a friend. Yeah, that's it. We have the elevation data based on SRTM. That's the worst data we have. The NASA published, I think, 2 years ago or last year, a new version of the SRTM data. We have it with the resolution of 30 meters per pixel for the whole globe. And for Europe and Austria, we used better data and scaled it down because of storage space. Are there any questions for this? No. If the profile is possible before building up, or yes, when I build up or when we build up a link, we look in the we want to find a point which we recognize, and then point it the first time. Then the same on the other side, and then we make it on the based on the signal strength.
Can you go with the antenna?
No, but most of the time pointed on a antenna pole or something, and then align it. And for testing, of course, I use a photo tripod and point it with this one. Yeah, thank you. It's the work of a whole group of people, and yeah, I only made the web front end and the data collection.